more on this. I'm joined now by Mio Aung Myint, a former member of Myanmar's ruling NLD party and a former spokesman for the leader Aung San Suu Kyi. Good to have you with us. Thank you very much indeed for joining us. So Human Rights Watch has accused Myanmar's government of crimes against humanity and says that it should be sanctioned. What's your response to that?
I don't think it's at the very fair for that in the very beginning of the conflict last 4 weeks ago, because of the ASR, the ERSA, which is the Muslim terrorist group, attacked the police forces, and they also recruited the villagers, and they also, that according to our report, showing that they also pushed the Rohingya, so-called Rohingya, I mean, civilian, innocent civilian, cross the border because of to get a wall attention. So this is why that the right now that's only a speculation and, you know, the allegations that, yeah, of course, you see
well,
that.
Can I just say that Human Rights Watch say it's not speculation. They say they have evidence supported by satellite imagery of forced displacement of people, of murder, of rape and of persecution. They say they have evidence of this.
Yeah, that's we like to know about the hard evidence, because, you know, today that the 2 days already that the Hindu community were killed by the Muslim extremists, and then 47 bodies were recovered from the 3 mass graveyards. So that was then kind of, you know, the wall attention over that. Of course, I'm really sorry for the innocent people who crossed the border, who left their homes, and the burning of houses. And because the military has no, you know, the loss control, because the government controlled the military and they have to follow the constitution, and constitution would not allow any military to act alone. That was the very frame up the some international attention. So I'm only worried that we have two separate issues, because one is that the minority Muslims live in, been, you know, hundreds of years ago in Yangon, Mandalay, you name it. And then we also have like three groups who has been British colonial government recklessly brought it, you know, into Myanmar as at the farming
leaders. Can I just ask, do you agree that the military response in Rakhine State has been disproportionate, which is the accusation that's been levelled at it by the EU, by the UN and several individual countries, including the US?
So this is the problem. Actually, the base of the root cause of the problem is that the lack of information and then disinformation by the government and the military, because it's my knowledge that there are only less than 2,000 of the military personnel sent over there for the only operation against the terrorists.
So why doesn't Myanmar allow in UN observers and investigators so that we can get to the bottom of what's happening in Rakhine State?
So I totally agree with you. The government should have, you know, allowed the international observer and international media to look at it, what really happened. Because when we look at it, more than hundreds of the Rakhine native, the innocent people got killed by the Muslim extremists, and then also 13 police, the personnel were killed by the, beheaded by the Muslim, they call that ASR group, the terrorist group. So, you know, why the government should have let the international observer to see that it's really on the ground. And then one thing, the according to my account, source said that the military should have the martial law to control the both sides, because right now that the government allow only the operation against the terrorism. So that's a problem that the some accounts saying
okay.
That the
I'm so sorry. We're going to have to leave it there. Really interesting to speak with you. Thank you very much indeed for that. Mio Aung Myint there.
Thank you.